in 1936, there was a kidnapping and attempt robbery of the bank. Mr. Blackmur, having returned home late one evening from going to the movies, was kidnapped at his home in leaving the garage adjacent, well, it wasn't adjacent to the house, but close to the house. And he and Wilson Keel and Dudley Kelly were kidnapped and taken out east of town. But in the first proceedings or events of that, Mr. Blackmur thought it was someone playing a prank on him. So he put his hand on one of the kidnappers' shoulders and proceeded to joke with him, at which time he was struck on the back of the head with the butt of a pistol and knocked out. Needless to say, they could not get in the bank because the vaults were under time lock. An attempt was made by coming down to the premises and had to be shown the fact that the vault doors wouldn't open. So the net result of this was that they got what pocket change and a watch in the automobile, but before the three men who were the kidnappers, they tied Mr. Blackmore on the back seat of the automobile with makeshift wire and baling wire and things and left him out in the woods. They later found the automobile and apprehended the kidnappers, and through the trial that occurred, only one of them was sent to prison, and that was due to the fact that positive identification couldn't be made to the other two because they had their faces blackened, and this was prevented positive identification. But after serving what was some time, he was released, and he came back by Water Valley and offered his apologies to Mr. Blackmur, because Mr. Blackmur signed what was his parole agreement, which was ahead of his serving his full time of his sentence.